my channel or welcome to new members of our community. I'm very happy to see you. My name is Yasa. I'm a violinist and I moved from Saint Petersburg, Russia to United States all by myself already almost 10 years ago. And I just like to talk about two countries that are very near and dear to my heart, Russia and United States, and giving you some scoop on both of the countries as a foreigner, as an outsider. I'm not afraid of that word, as an outsider who is looking from the distance on both countries and both cultures. I made a video about New Year and celebration of that holiday in Russia, and this is part two because I realized I haven't told you so many things that I would like to tell you about that. And plus, I can talk about this topic forever. So, okay, so I wanted to mention that in Russia, we are very much influenced by different countries. And this is very natural, right? Because we have huge territory, we have so many, because with huge territory comes a huge amount of borders that we have. So we have borders with so many countries. And even though we don't have a border with France, we are hugely influenced by France. For example, novelty of our novelty of 18th, 19th century spoke French better than perhaps Russian, and many books, for example, Tolstoy, Dostoevsky, the writing, half of it is maybe less than half is in French. So, you know, it's very interesting to understand that now, because our food that goes on the celebratory table, a lot of it comes from French. Our famous salad Olivier, our dessert Napoleon comes from, of course, famous leader of France and of the beginning of 19th century, Napoleon. And we have huge border with China, so a lot of influence comes from China. So for example, how it's connected to New Year, we are very much fascinated and having lots of fun with those Chinese belief, with the Chinese belief of animals representing specific years. So for example, I was born in 1989, and this is a year of snakes. So every 12 years my sign keeps coming back, and this is a special year for that animal. Every 12 years there is that cycle, right? So every year we are very particular. We're noticing what year is it by figuring of that animal. For example, I'm not following that tradition anymore here, but I know that that was a year of a rooster, I think, right? Or a pig. you see how bad I am with that. But for example, if it's a year of a rooster, have a little figure of a rooster, you give, you feed the animal, you put a little bit of food in front of him to please him, to make him like you this year and to bring you luck this year. So that's very important. And also there are certain colors that you want to wear associated with that animal. So mom would usually tell me, okay, so it's a year of a rooster, we have to have red colors. And I don't have anything red, so I have to find something in the last second, like a scarf or something, just a little bit to incorporate those colors that's supposed to please the sacred animal of that year. So that is something I find that we don't really pay attention here, right? This is something that is really big in Russia, and we get those souvenirs with, you know, all keychains and maybe candles in the shape of that animal. Another tradition I wanted to mention is a very interesting tradition to celebrate second New Year. So it sounds funny, but also because of change of the calendars in the past, we now ended up having two New Years. So we have 31st to the 1st, and then 2 weeks later, from January 13th to January 14th, we have a second New Year. We call it All New Year. And it's as big as a celebration as before. Well, maybe a little bit less. We still have all our singers and anchors and comedians perform for us on the TV. We have all the movies again and maybe some new ones. And we get together again and celebrate. And it's a bit of a less of a celebration, of course, than the original New Year on the 31st. But it's still in our minds and hearts, and we all have to celebrate it. Now, lately, for the past couple of years, well, I would say maybe even a decade, the past decade, we've been able to celebrate for a long period of time. I believe some of the workers get time off as much as a week off. So with all the holidays put together, you kind of can make it work like you off from work from the 31st to maybe 10th of January. So if all the holidays put together, you get a pretty long break. So a lot of people lately, not in pandemic, of course, but past years, they like to travel. So they go to different countries just to have their winter break, right? So they get vacations on summer and in winter. That is another interesting thing that, you know, we celebrate a lot in Russia. We like our time off. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please, if you can, like and subscribe. And I will see you again. And let's have a really, really nice New Year celebration and happy holiday season, everyone. Bye. Пока.